Love is not proud. Love does not boast. Love, after all, matters the most. Love does not run. Love does not hide. Love does not keep locked inside. Love is a river that flows through, and love never fails you. Love will sustain, love will provide, love will not cease at the end of time. And love will protect, love always hopes, and love still believes when you don't. Love is the arms that are holding you. Love never fails.
I would like to just express to Kim and Matt just what an honor it is to be standing here with them to celebrate their marriage and to participate as the person officiating it. Matt and I go back to Matt and his family from the time he was 9 years old, back to 1993, and him and his family have been a huge part of my life ever since. But Kim's family, I met in 1987 when we lived on the same street on Lagana Lane in Shelton. So Kim will always know me way before Matt. So having said that, let us begin. So on behalf of Kim and Matt, I would like to welcome all their loving family and friends. They are so absolutely thrilled that so many of you that mean so much to them are here to share with them one of life's greatest moments, the blending of two hearts, the joining of Kim and Matt in marriage. Now today, all of their families are not physically here, and Kim and Matt would like to pay a special tribute to them, starting with Kim's beloved grandfather, Peter Baldiga Sr., who passed away just less than 30 days ago on March 24th. Peter was the patriarch of the Baldiga family, and he very much looked forward to being here to celebrate another family milestone. Today and always in our memory, we keep Peter Baldiga Sr. In addition, the Baldiga family would like to remember Kim's grandparents, Joseph and Mary Trecca. Additionally, the Newsy family would like to remember Matt's grandparents, Gilbert and Ruth Wurst, Morris and Anita Newsy, and also Ida Newsy and Matt's sister, Anita Laura Newsy. None of them are here in body, but all of them are here in spirit and heart, and Kim and Matt would like to express their love for all of them. Now, most of you know that Kim is Catholic and Matt is Jewish, and today they come together from two very different and distinct traditions to learn the best of what each faith has to offer and to appreciate and embrace their differences. This wedding ceremony is being blessed under this beautiful huppah, a wedding canopy that in the Jewish faith is the symbol of a new home being consummated here. Later we'll have a unity candle ceremony, which in the Christian faith symbolizes two people joining as one in marriage.
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, and as in today, tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children, the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch.
Thank you. I, Kimberly.
Take you, Matthew.
Take you, Matthew.
To be my beloved husband.
To be my beloved husband.
To have.
To have.
And to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
I promise.
I promise.
To be true to you.
To be true to you.
In good times.
In good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
Sickness.
Sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And will honor you.
And will honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Matthew.
I, Matthew.
Take you, Kimberly.
Take you, Kimberly.
To be my beloved wife.
To be my beloved wife.
To have.
To have.
And to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
I promise.
I promise.
To be true.
To be true.
To you in good times.
To you in good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
Sickness.
Sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
It will honor you.
And honor you.
All the days.
All the days.
Of my life.
Of my life.
Step one. That's great.
Almost there.
Okay, next, we're going to have the exchanging of the rings. Now, these rings are tokens of the continuity and integrity of your love for each other. May they embody the enduring trust and affection that you bring to one another. Now, Matt has chosen to get married in the same ring that belonged to his father, Neil, and his grandfather, Mo. Danny, if you could give Kim.
Which hand?
So Kim, as you place this ring in Matt's fingers, we'll read the vows, we'll read the ceremony out loud. With this ring. I join my life.
With yours.
This is a symbol.
Of my eternal love.
Everlasting friendship.
And promise.
Of all my tomorrows.
Good job.
Okay, Matt, your turn.
Well, they multiplied.
Okay, so let's. With this ring. I join my life.
With yours.
This is a symbol.
Of my eternal love.
Everlasting friendship. And promise.
Of all my tomorrows. That's as far as we're going to get. There you go.
The significance of the unity candle, if you'd understand, is not just that the families are joined and you're joined, but this unity will continue to develop as you're married, but the external flames will continue to stay lit to show that together you also may remain as individuals. I'm told there are many different explanations for the breaking of the glass, but each shares a belief that the fragility of the glass suggests the frailty of this relationship. And traditionally, the glass is broken to protect and bless this marriage with the implied prayer, and it's really beautiful. May your bond of love be as difficult to break as it would be to put together all the pieces of this glass. Mazel tov! May God's countenance shine upon you and be gracious to you. May God look upon you with favor and grant you peace and good health. And listen to this, ladies and gentlemen, by the power vested in me, by the state of Connecticut, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Matt, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you for the first time in public as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Matt Newsy.